Picture this. You're driving down the road and you're listening to music or listening to your favorite podcast. Maybe you're just musing on your thoughts. And then all of a sudden, lightning strikes. You have a brilliant idea. But what are you going to do with it? Are you going to pull off to the side of the road? Do you frantically hold onto the steering wheel and scramble trying to find a pen in your bag? Well, if you're like me, you turn to Google Keep. Hey guys, it's Itai Emma, and you're watching Full Field, where we focus on the latest video tools and techniques and frame the conversation just for you. In my business, or in my life really, I'm always looking for ways to be more efficient, more productive. If you've searched for tricks on how to be more productive, then I'm sure you've probably come across Getting Things Done by David Allen. Originally published in 2011, GTD has grown from a productivity method to what honestly feels like a religion. A Google search for GTD will return 14 million results. And among those results, there is a litany of products and tools and apps for implementing the various stages of GTD. The first step in getting things done is capturing. Capturing anything and everything that has your attention. You can use a sticky note or a note card, or a random piece of paper will do. The key is you have to capture everything. And for that, what you need is what we call a ubiquitous capturing tool. That's where Google Keep comes in. Google Keep has the ability to capture both handwritten and typewritten notes. You can also take photos and make checklists or record an audio note. Audio notes are automatically transcribed into text, and that's where the juice is. So if we go back to my driving example, all you need to do to capture that great idea is hit the audio note button and speak your brilliance into the air. It's really that simple. Another tool that's been heavily adopted by the GTD community is EVERNOTE. EVERNOTE is sort of your long-term memory. It's the place to store all of your reference materials. You can create and maintain your list there as well. It's great for that. But creating notes on the fly, not so much. When Google Keep was first introduced, many people saw it as a potential successor to EVERNOTE, myself included. I mean, after all, you can save and archive notes, you can tag them, and best of all, Google Keep is free. That thinking was a mistake, and that, I think, is why many of us GTDers passed on Keep. Keep has its shortfalls in comparison to EVERNOTE. I mean, it's not ideal for sorting and storing reference materials once you hit a certain critical mass of notes. The ability to stack notes and notebooks and tag everything in EVERNOTE, it's just too good. But again, capture is where Keep really shines. With the photo and audio note features, Google Keep is ideal for capturing notes on the go. When I'm driving and an idea pops into my head, I capture an audio note. When I'm doing my weekly review process, I use Keep. I go around my house and I take photos of everything that might have my attention. Then when it comes to emptying my inboxes, I go back to Google Keep and I look at the items that I've captured. See, now we're getting into the clarify phase of GTD. I'll either do that thing right then, use the note to update my to-do list, or share the note to EVERNOTE for reference. Another nice feature in Keep are the reminders. In EVERNOTE and pretty much every productivity app you can find, you can set time-based reminders. Keep is the only app that I've seen that has location-based reminders. It's great to have a grocery list, but it doesn't do you much good if you don't think to look at it while you're at the store. The GPS location on your phone will trigger a Keep reminder. It's really nice to be reminded of things when you're where you need to be reminded of them. The Getting Things Done methodology is all about creating systems, and I have yet to find one app to rule them all. Now, if you've looked at Google Keep in the past and didn't think it was a really good fit for you, I'd like to recommend that you give it a second look. Like me, you were probably trying to get it to do more than what it's actually best at. I'm a productivity fanatic, so if you have some of your favorite tools and you'd like to share them, please leave them in the notes in the comments below. And if you like this or any of my videos, I'd like to invite you to click the subscribe button to get notifications and get your weekly dose of video tradecraft framed and in focus. I'm Itai Emma, you've been watching Full Field, and we'll see you next time.